Hello everybody, my name is Rachel and I am here at the Keilor Library. Today we are going to be doing Kid Zone and I'm going to teach you how to make your very own bird feeder. So what we will need is a milk carton, and this can't have any milk in it, so it's got to be once you finish the milk. We also need some icy pole sticks. We'll probably need 4 of these, I think. We will also need things to decorate our milk carton with. So I've chosen some stickers, lots of stars and shiny stickers to attract the birds. And you'll also need some paint. So I've chosen some purple paint or some green paint. But if you don't have paint at home, you could use coloured paper, or you could use textures, you could use an old newspaper to decorate your milk carton. Now, some other things that we'll need. You'll need a pen or a black texter. You'll also need a ruler, or perhaps you could use one of these icy pole sticks to draw a line. And of course, you will need some bird seed. And in this one, I can see there's a few different things that birds like to eat. We've got some popcorn that hasn't been popped, just the kernels. We've got some pumpkin seeds, and lots of other seeds and grains that birds really enjoy eating. So let's get started, and the first thing we have to do is paint our milk carton. So I have chosen 2 different colours. I'm going to start with the purple, and we'll see how we go. Everyone, so I have painted my milk carton purple. It's going to be a purple bird feeder. And the next step that we need to do is cut out the windows that the birds are going to eat through. So to do that, you'll need a texter and a ruler. If you can't find a ruler, you could use one of the icy pole sticks or anything straight in your house, really. And we are going to draw some windows. And then what we'll do is we'll cut them out. So I've drawn my windows onto the bird feeder. And now we're going to grab some scissors, or if you have a Stanley knife at home and mum and dad can help you, maybe a brother and sister. We're going to cut these windows out now. So there is our bird feeder. You can see it's got 2 windows that birds can come out and eat from. And now we're going to decorate this. So to decorate my bird feeder, I'm going to choose lots of shiny stickers to see how many birds I can get. But you could use anything. You could use coloured paper, you could use textures, you could use cut up magazines or newspapers and glue your favourite pictures on there. Anything you like, you could even write your name. So I'm going to get started and I'll show you what it looks like at the end. Okay, now that we have decorated our bird feeder, it's time to use the icy pole sticks to make a little perch for the bird to sit on so it can feed out of here. Okay, so to do that, you will need your scissors or a Stanley knife again, and it might be a good idea to get one of your parents or grandparents or brothers or sisters to help you with this if you need it. And you're just going to be cutting a little line into the milk carton that will allow an icy pole stick just to fit through. Just like this. And that's what the bird's going to be perching on whilst it eats out of our window here. So do that to the other side, and then if you wanted to do some perches higher up as well, you can do that. there we go. We've got our two little perches for the bird to sit on. And the last step now is to put some string in the top. So we can hang it from a tree or at your front door, really anywhere you would like. So I've got some white string here, but if you don't have string, you could use old shoelaces. You could use many different things. All right, there we go. We've got our very own bird feeder that you can hang in a tree, or you can hang in your backyard or your front yard. The final step is to put the bird feed into the feeder. So let's give it a go. And there we have it. As you can see, the bird can sit up here and it can feed on all of that bird seed inside. I wonder if the birds in my garden will like this. Give it a go and let us know how you go. Come in and show us pictures when the library reopens, or of course you can post them to Facebook or Instagram to show us before then. I hope you enjoyed today's activity, everybody. And please check out our other videos on YouTube as well, because there's so many that you can be doing after school. Enjoy and have a lovely day. Bye.